I've got that solved. I actually wrote a paper in 2002, but nobody in Wyoming has the courage to do it. And I'm a guy that's willing to do it because I know the law. How do you know the law? Because it's every citizen's obligation to know it. And one of these things is 2% service tax. You don't like hearing it, but there it is. 2% service tax on everybody in Wyoming. Everybody pays. And the reason we do that is we regenerate growth in Wyoming. And what does that do? We could set it just like the Mineral Trust Fund. We don't have to keep it forever and ever. We set it for 10 years or 15 years or 12, whatever you want. That's the legislators. We've got the rules on the Permanent Mineral Trust Fund. We just incorporate service tax. Why? I'll give you a real simple answer. Semi crashes on the interstate. Flips over. $50,000 to clean up that mess. Do you pay taxes on it? No. This tow truck driver doesn't pay a dang thing. So take 2% of 50 grand. And that's 11 to 12 vehicles just in my area in the winter. I say it's time we taxed ourselves.
I'm a businessman, and what I look at on a day-to-day basis is how we spend money. And I see the state spends money at the top level. At the top level of state funding can be cut. So I don't see where, and there's a difference between necessity and convenience. And that can be illustrated by the two jet airplanes that the state of Wyoming has as a convenience, not a necessity. That's just one small example. So I offer this, is that we'll take care of the needs of the people of Wyoming. That's a constitutional charge, is welfare of the people of Wyoming. And we'll cut the spending at the top to provide that extra dollars going out there. And also we can diversify our business. There's ideas that I have for that that will help strengthen the economy. And industrial hemp is one of them, matter of fact. And so these are things that we can bring to the table. And all of us working together can improve our state and also identify the need and also the convenience part of the spending.
I think one of the things we have to guard against is more increases in taxes. Personal property taxes can go up. We could increase sales tax. Some people talk about income tax. So to safeguard Wyomingites' financial stability, we have to do everything we can to forestall any additional tax increases. And we have enormous opportunities if we look at the budget and how we can cut those deficits. If we could open the books, which has happened in 47 states, Wyoming, North Carolina, and California have not made the checkbooks of the state available to the people, and that's basically unacceptable. We have seen already by the few that have revealed, there's 850 government entities in Wyoming that should be revealing them, and the ones that have, we've seen a teacher's seminar where they decided they needed entertainment, and they hired a magician for $35,000. There's another $15,000 documentary approved for the Dutch hop dance. I have no idea what it is. So basically, we must control the budget, get rid of the non-bid contracts, and make sure we know how every penny is spent. And by holding expenses back, that's going to be the best benefit to help our Wyomingite senior citizens.
Well, I believe the number one goal in our state is to control our state spending. And the reason for that is the more money that we waste at the state level, the less money we have to deliver services to our residents. More importantly, we have less money to deliver services to our elderly and more senior residents. I have spent a lifetime solving large complex problems and seizing large-scale opportunities. I look forward to the opportunity to adjusting Wyoming's cost structure and delivering a higher level of service at a lower cost for not only our senior residents, but all residents in the state.
You know, as Wyoming goes forward, we're accustomed to this boom and bust cycle, and we have just recently experienced something of a bust. We're starting to see a little bit of a recovery, and so Wyoming is in a pretty good situation. What I'd say as treasurer over the last several years is we've done our best to be able to improve returns to help augment any shortfalls we'd see on our mineral side. This is important because roughly anywhere from the second or the third largest input into our revenue stream comes from our investments at this point. I would continue to support the Treasurer's Office to make sure that happens. From a budgetary standpoint, I think it is incredibly important that Wyoming have a good sense of priorities. And our seniors and our people of age 50 and over are a priority and absolutely have made this state, and I will go to bat for them daily.
This is another issue that I have addressed extensively while on the campaign trail. The reality is the state of Wyoming is number one in terms of the size of our government per capita, and we're number 50 in terms of transparency, and I believe that the two are related. We need to look at the spending side, and we need to be looking at good government. We need to be looking at our budgets. We need to be looking at transparency, and we also need to be evaluating our programs to ensure that they are effective, efficient, transparent, responsive, and responsible. I do not believe that this is the time to raise taxes in Wyoming, especially for many of our seniors who may be on fixed incomes. I believe that we need to look at the spending side of it, and that is where I am going to be focused. I'm going to be working with the legislature on budget reform and also transparency. I do think that that is a critical issue. I believe that in Wyoming, we will be able to provide the services that our citizens want and need without raising taxes. But I also think that we need to prioritize. And prioritizing it will include taking care of our seniors. That is an incredibly important issue to me.
Thank you for that question, because the term budget cuts and revenues has become a buzzword which are almost meaningless except to frighten people. In my platform, there is a place where we will add at least $1 billion a year to Wyoming coffers. And we will definitely not slight our seniors in any program, because these are the people that got us to where we are. They are our responsibility as they age and as they're unable to care for themselves. So I will use some of that $1 billion annually to cover any costs we need to care for our elderly people.
Well, I'd like to change the question a little bit just to emphasize that the first thing we need to do in Wyoming is acknowledge that we cannot continue as a boom and bust state. And that means we have to take a long, hard look at how we generate revenue in the state so that we have enough revenue for all necessary government services, including for people over the age of 50. We cannot continue to rely nearly exclusively on coal, oil, and natural gas to fund our state government. And I've really been clear on that from the beginning. But for people over 50, one of the most important things the state needs to do, and it should have done 4 or 5 years ago, is to expand Medicaid. I can't tell you how many people I have met across the state who are working or who have had jobs and no longer have health insurance, and they're over 50. And speaking from personal experience as a cancer survivor, being over 50 is the worst time in your life to not have access to regular health care.